Milwaukee County Sheriff says his department would take a sample from anyone as soon as they're arrested. Now, the arrest of accused serial killer Walter Ellis revealed a 12,000 name gap in the state felon DNA database. 12 News' Nick Bohr is live at the jail. And Nick, this would take a change in state law.
Well, it would, and it would also create a significant workload for the state crime lab and significantly increase the number of profiles in that state DNA database. However, Sheriff David Clarke already has his supporters, including a state lawmaker who says he's already drafting a bill.
The case of accused serial killer Walter Ellis brought to light a major shortcoming in the current system of recording a DNA profile for every convicted felon in the state. Some 12,000 of them apparently aren't listed. That means the profiles of 10% of the people who should be in it weren't taken or were lost.
DNA is the fingerprint of the 21st century. So here's what I'm proposing. If the Attorney General wants the DNA of those arrested for crimes in our communities captured and processed by a group with a proven record of getting it done, the sheriffs can handle it for them.
Under Sheriff Clarke's proposal, a DNA sample would be taken during booking at the jail, along with fingerprints and mug shots already obtained.
I think this is a reasonable direction to go.
Milwaukee County DA John Chisholm says it would get the DNA into the system more quickly. But the Wisconsin American Civil Liberties Union has concerns about police possibly trolling for suspects.
Police could be tempted to arrest somebody and bring them in for a DNA sample when they really know that the charge isn't going to stick, but they want to have a DNA sample.
But supporters say a similar system already exists in 15 other states with constitutional safeguards in place.
Almost all the states have a felony requirement. It's felony DNA collection. So a person's arrested for a felony offense, the sample is taken. If at some point in time a decision is made that there isn't sufficient evidence to charge the case, there's provisions for expungement in place that requires the destruction of the DNA.
And that's not to mention concerns about the expense of this plan, but State Senator Jeff Plaley believes that all those issues can be ironed out over the coming weeks in legislation that he'll be drafting in the next few weeks. Reporting live at the county jail, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.